Yeah.
Hello.
Okay.
Hello. I'm Anuj Nigam. I'm from company Startling Solar Private Limited. We are a rooftop solar company based out of Mumbai, but our operations are mainly in the northern area. So what that EP, being a EPC company and facing the same problems like net metering and all that, what my assumption is that we are facing the problem because unfortunately all the rooftop solar companies are not having a common platform. See, we all are going to MNRE, but we get overshadowed by the big companies who are doing the megawatt projects. And let's see, like even for example, today we are discussing all these problems. But who is one person who is responsible for doing this? Nobody is here in the crowd. So what we should do, actually form an association and contact to those people who are responsible for fixing the accountability. You see, if steel companies and all that can get even thousands of crores of loans restructuring. Okay, we are not so big companies, the rooftop solar EP companies, to be honest, but we are huge in numbers. So if 40 companies go and like complain to the minister or not complain, actually make a presentation that this kind of accountability is missing or this kind of things have to be set in, a lot of things can be done. Unfortunately, the rooftop solar company is the only place where we are meeting is in the customer's background, in the customer's office where we are competing for L1 and nothing else. So once we form a closed session and discuss with the right people in the government authority as a group, I think most of the problems can be solved and accountability can be fixed. In fact, Uday, you are very lucky that you got a chance to get the net meter. In one of the states, they neither gave the net meter, they neither allowed us to procure, and they made us work 6 months. Because they say we'll release a tender for procuring net meter and then only it can be installed. And the customer finally held up our 20% of payment till the last moment. Yeah, unless net meter is there, the installation is no use to me. So this is how the problems we are facing, but any single company would never like to antagonize the government officials. So as a group, if we go, then definitely it can make a big change, and I'm sure that it will make do. That's what my humble submission is there.
Yep. Mic over here, please.
Hi, my name is Parag Bhamre. I represent a company called Absent Power Private Limited. I heard a lot of talk about quality, a lot of talk about the costing. One of the experiences that we had, similar to the gentleman from Everest Solar, we were bidding for a project, and actually the project, it was a large project, somewhere above 500 kilowatts, was quoted at 33 rupees. So this was something which was really astonishing for us. So one of the, and there were about 10 to 12 bidders in that particular segment. And when we heard that, we basically came up with an idea, and that's an idea that I wanted to just share with everyone and maybe could be used everywhere. Together with the Solar Association, we've decided to float a white paper which would actually talk about the different components which go into a good solar power plant, including the modules, the inverters, the BOS system, and give some sort of an indicative pricing. And this would be a white paper which would be published by a solar association and not by a particular company, which could be used by various EPC players, at least the good ones could use it, to show to their customers that these are the real prices. And what we had proposed is that we would actually be publishing such a white paper quarter on quarter to keep in line with what are the price changes that are happening in the market, because this is a rapidly changing market. If we could use such a white paper to prove to somebody or the customer really doesn't know. The customer, they have some sort of an idea, but at the end of the day, they do go with L1. And to ensure that quality projects do come up, if we are armed with such a white paper, we can show to the customer that this is the real cost of it. Now, if you decide to go with somebody L1, he is aware of the risk. Right now, solar is not like any of the branded cars. You cannot make a distinction between a Mercedes and a, you know, I wouldn't like to name any other car, but there is no way to distinguish this at this point in time. The customer only realizes later.
Yeah, I think this is the churning which need to take place. In fact, the government has to come out also very harshly. Like if the EPC players are supplying faulty material, not according to the standards, the government should come out strongly and blacklist those companies. In fact, there is a lot of public procurement that takes place in the country. At least if that public procurement, if the government comes with a strong hand, I think there would be a lot of discipline. Today, the challenge starts with the largest quantum of procurement, that is a public procurement. With the SECI coming out with the large number of bids for And then the state nodal agencies coming up with different types of bids with absolutely no check. Like, I don't want to name the state, but you know, there are several states which have come out with the bids. And these SNS don't even have staff to complete the paperwork. There is a question of they going on to the site and the checking whether it is according to the standard. So many a times these SNS just sign the paper which has been received by them. If it has been received through somebody, it is done faster. If it comes directly, it is done later. Frankly, that's the reality of life. So, you know, I think while I absolutely agree with you on the quality issue, the price benchmarking, if even if it is done, I am a little skeptical about how much useful or how much it will be used. But if the government comes back and implements, appoints few agencies, as I said, we do to some extent a similar kind of work which Uday mentioned about the quality of the panels. We do the performance audit of the projects. And we have come across the projects which were of atrocious quality. That's the only, right. only word I can use. It's, as I said, three different types of panels connected to the same string. Okay, clearly the projects which have come up with a very, very, very pathetic galvanized structures. The right. screws so, which have been, or the nut bolts which have been used are not galvanized at all. The cables are not connected properly. Connectors are of pathetic quality. So, you know, these are the pervasive problems unless and until there is some blacklisting. The government coming in and doing it the best way so that the government shows that what is quality, what is not quality. And since the sector is driven by the government has to do it.
Right. I had just proposed this for private business. So as an EPC company, if I'm going to a private customer, to be honest, the government will, they have their hands full, to be honest. And rooftop right now is not priority for them. That's the sense that I get right now. That we've not scaled up enough and they're probably going to lower that target. So for private business, this is something which could be useful because at the end of the day, me as an EPC player going to a customer can, if armed with such a thing, can show him that, hey, look, this is the real price. I need some proof.
I agree with you because, for example, your suggestion could be taken by consulting agencies such as Bridge to India or Mercom. Etc., where they come out with a kind of a white paper, exactly. Like what you suggested, indicating different component prices as well as what kind of components needs to be used. Because already MNRE has created, they already created a benchmark for what kind of materials needs to be used and specs already is there. If you can see the MNRE website, you will find that it is already available. And so it's only this thing which needs to be done by these agencies, which can help in driving towards, at least in the commercial and industrial space, a certain standard set for the quality, because I think it is going to help in ensuring that the industry thrives and sustains, because ultimately end of the day or a 25-year period, the investment should give the return on, it should give return on investment. Otherwise, why will you find people coming in to invest? Otherwise, you can find the likes of Cleantech, Cleanmax or any of these people who get, who are investing in the OPEX. Will not be there at all. I mean, especially with the kind of, now with the prices on modules and the kind of uncertainty in the market at the moment, the OPEX rate should be very close to the DISCOM prices at some places, especially in the case of Maharashtra with cross subsidy and etc. So it is going to be, that will be quite a helpful suggestion what you have come out with. Probably we should work towards each one of us to ensure that such a kind of a paper is released.
Yeah,
this is going to be through an association and it's not a particular company's paper that we are going to be coming out with.
Okay, one last question if there is one.
My name is Kapil from Fortum. So just as a comment, see the falling prices in the utility scale, do you feel that is also affecting the solar rooftop, open access and B2B market? Because when I'm pretty much sure the sharp fall in the tariff would be adversely affecting this market.
Okay, I would like to end this session on a good note. Okay, I was fortunate to be associated with the first vision document which was prepared in the country for solar sector, and way back in 2007. And that was a little private initiative, and we had it in Bangalore, where close to 300 people attended. We had invited a legendary Harman Scheer to open the event in Bangalore. And for that event, we had prepared the vision document, and we set a ambitious target of 5,000 megawatt by 2022. Okay, and in fact, most of us were confident that we won't achieve it. Okay, because in 2007, talking about a 5,000 megawatt of solar was kind of a blasphemous, frankly enough. Okay, subsequently in 2010, when the government talked about 20,000 megawatt by 2022, I think many in industry, probably most of us over here, were also thought what we are talking about. 20,000 megawatt is a huge number. But today we have crossed 20,000 megawatt. By 2022, whether we would achieve 100,000 megawatt or not, okay, I think we would somewhere be in the region of 60 to 80,000 megawatt or 60, 75,000 megawatt. And that's really the great achievement for the sector as a whole. Well, there are challenges. I think let's be optimistic that we will be able to take care of these challenges and move forward. Okay, I would request all of you to give big round of applause for all the panelists over here, and I will hand over to Anand.
Indeed, very, very interesting discussions in this session. I would like to thank all the panelists on the stage. Really highly appreciate your presence and sparing some valuable time with us. So I'll request now Balwanji to give small mementos to all the speakers on the dais.
Thank you.